Hello everybody and welcome to another fine round of GPVWC here on simrace.tv. We're here for the World Series. And my name is Simon Smith and I'll be taking you through the 24 laps of action here at the Montreal circuit for round 4 of 6 of this mini season, which has kept us clinging onto the edge of our seats. Like some kind of lemon in a do-I-don't-I kind of gaze. Joining me on cameras, as ever, is Simon Melhuish, who constantly trollolls his way through each broadcast, and will be providing you with all your eye candy and pixelated fun and juices. So, all big your hats. And in visual good is, I do not mean whatever is hidden behind Sporran in a secret Scottish evening. Now we're just moving forward into warm-up around this circuit that is a lot of people's favourite when it comes to racing calendar in general. I personally love this circuit, it's got great flow to it, lots of bouncing across the kerbs. I suppose if you want to do one of those awful music videos where they're all bouncing their cars up like 12 feet into this guy and the Lady Silicon bounces a few steps behind, this is a good place to do it across the kerbs here. Plenty of room for overtaking, plenty of room for drama, possibly pit stops as well. Very short pit lane here, which is made all the more tempting for the fact that you don't have to brake for turn one because you bypassed it entirely, and you don't necessarily have to brake and bounce and try out the wall of champions at the final chicane either. You've got a nice straight entrance into it. Although, it remains to be seen quite what tyre wear does to everyone around here. Quite a lot of driver penalties came out from the bashful Monte Carlo race. 8 drivers, including Simon Cattell, have a penalty. And of course the championship standings as it stands at the moment, which is quite funny for a standing, Boy Vandelaar and Borna Spoljaric equal on points with 47 apiece, just one ahead of a silent assassin, Marek Skijnowski, with Alex Cooper just a further 2 behind him on 44 points in 4th, and a gap back to Tom Parker in 5th, and Kyrol Aziz 6 with Cattell 7, Boyd Bryson 8, Lucas Euler 9, and David Junt rounding out the top 10 equal with Bart DeVos. So, plenty to play for here today. And a couple of, well, one in particular new man on top of the league standings when it came to qualifying. And quite sure what relation he is to some of the men that we may know for motor racing themselves. It remains to be seen, but it's an MSC at the top, Martin Schumacher. For Midnight Racing, Midnight Motorsports, taking pole position here today. And it's been a while since we've seen a Schumacher on the top of a standing, albeit a digital format. And pleasure to see. We'll see. In fact, someone just gets an image of their nose and chin and kind of superimpose it onto a little bit of black paper. We might be able to see whether or not it's actually Michael just trying it out, just for fun. Don't forget, you can join us and toddle along with the action over the GPVWC broadcast page, which you can get from gpvwc.com, where you can also sign up for all the action, where myself, me and I are in the broadcasting chat room. You can come and have a little chinwag along. Normally we have a few regulars popping down, so be sure to join us there. And of course, you can tweet as well at GPVWC, or for myself actually, because I keep myself on there, and that's at Satoriman. So you're all more than welcome to get yourself interactive, because you know me, I like to try and get my hands on as much as possible, and possibly put it in my mouth, so you want to stay quite close. The driver's just being told that they can run out to the Wall of Champions on the final turn. Of course, the rest of the circuit very much stay on the tarmac, and in qualifying and in practice, so many of the drivers losing it into turns 1 and 2, the first chicane, also on the exit of turn 2, the chicane there. And the pit lane as well. Too many people just taking their outside wheels onto the grass and off they go. So anyone that's doing a pit stop, try not to. A few people into the barriers at the second chicane as well, just on the exit, which is always one that comes to bite you. Not so many people into the Wall of Champions terminally, but certainly they're bending their axles. And wishbones. Possibly a collarbone. Not sure. We'll soon find out. Hip bones connected to the thigh bone. Dim bones, dim bones, dim. I've got to stop already. I think we're just waiting for Tom Parker to see if he can rejoin the server. I think he's just had a wee bit of a problem. Currently, we've got 33 drivers on the grid. Yep, Tom's disappeared, so we're on. So, we shall see. We should take you down through the grid as they all start to prepare. Poor old Tom Parker. Doesn't have much luck with his internet connection. Bet you're with Virgin. So the grid penalties, we had Simon Cattell have a 5-place grid penalty. Eric Veit had a 10-place. Kyril Aziz a 15-place. My God, what did he do? Molest someone? Mike Schroten, plus 5. Christoph Lichtenstein, plus 5. Does that really matter? Marcus Sundström, plus 15. And Daniel Lovett obviously was loving it a little bit too much and had plus 10. As Martin Schumacher leads us round for a Midnight Motorsport all front row. After penalties were handed out, Cattell was alongside, but he's had a 5-place drop. Alongside him will be fourth in the championship, Alex Cooper, for Midnight Motorsport. Then in typical Noah's Ark fashion, Bonus Body Oak and Boy Vandalar, row 2 for Torrent Motorsports. David Stand, an excellent 5th for DSR, the highest I've seen him all season so far. Alongside Ryan Walker in 6th for Constant Racing, again a best for him. With Simon Cattell moved down to 7th for Inner Vision. We're going to have tunnel vision around all of these concrete barriers, with the second constant of Mark Stanton in 8th. So the Stanton brothers doing exceptionally well. Morten Bernardsson 9 for Royal Blue, ahead of Bart DeVos in 10 for Mazurek. Lee Massey 11 for Revolution Motorsport, desperately trying to keep it on the road in a warm-up lap. Not good there. Ari Niemelin for Milky Moo, and someone's off, I think, in the background there. Marek Skijnowski 13th. Followed by Stefan Gordon, 14 for Hawkeye. David Junt, 15 for Woods Racing, with Eric Veit, 16 for RMI after a penalty. Simon Crane, 17 for Walter Blue Racing, with Mark Wicks, 18 for Hydraulics, hoping for another good result after his Monte Carlo marathon of points. Halcyon Racing have got Wesley Morris in 19th, possibly related to Lee, I assume, with Ehab Abbas, 20th for Walter Blue. Then Whoopi Whoopi for the Hoekstra in 21st. They're not related to them apparently, but well, I may have just mated you together now, sorry. Jeff Mead, 22nd for Halcyon. Timo Bricker for Street Fighter in 23rd, with Matt Leonowitz for the second Revolution in 24th. Richard Bays, 25 for Epic Motorsports, going around the Epic hairpin, followed by Chris Williamson who was struggling for most of the quali, but he ended up 26th for the second Street Fighter. Gavin Thomas, last minute jive in and quick lap for Red 5 in 27, ahead of Nick Newcomb for FA Racing in 28th. Last time he really did do F1 racing as well, so let's hope that doesn't hold true today. Christian Prohaska, 30th for Cop Racing, hoping that he realises what a blue flag is today. Post Monaco, a very difficult one to make your debut on, so hopefully better from him. Christoph Lichtenstein, 31st for Red 5. Someone's off, in fact that is Prohaska. No, Prohaska, it's Daniel Lovett, sorry. Going off. Or is there just someone... Yeah, there's someone at the back there behind Marcus Sundström and Daniel Lovett, who's starting right at the back of the grid. And I'm oh, it's Kagiaglu, who should be 29th, starting at the back of the field. So I'm not quite sure what's going on there, but they're just lining themselves up. Hopefully he'll be able to thread himself back in again. Nice and wide, the start-finish straight, so you can squeeze someone with some food problems down in between the cars, should you need to. Quite a lot of lag there, so hopefully this will be sorted out quite soon. But here we are, ready to go. Round four is away, and Martin Schumacher gets away well as a Spoliarik. Cooper bogs down, and that's going to allow him to slip back to third. And Bourne is trying to weave between the two, goes back for second. Boy smacks Cooper as Schumacher goes across, and round goes Boy van der Laar. And someone's gone into the back, and it's Chaos Junts upside, not upside down. Mark Wicks is in the air. There's problems around. It's Marcus Vernonsen there who was caught behind. Mark Wicks also in trouble, rejoins at the very back. That's not worked out at all well, but Borna Spoliarik then takes the lead because Martin Schumacher has been in trouble, and that is Lee Massey that's gone off at the second chicane and is dropping down to 16th position. He's got a puncture, and if he's got to try and get that round, somehow Lazarus Kagiaglu has gone from 29th to 16th in four turns. But Lee Massey trying to race in 16th, now 17th position. But he's got a puncture and he needs to just let everyone through. And he smacks! What on earth was that? Get that man off the server. He's being a right moose as they continue down into the next chicane. We'll ignore him, I feel. As Spoliarik continues to go lead down into the hairpin. Ahead of Schumacher and Cooper. Then Stanton into fourth. Cattell up five. Then Walker, Nemean, Veit, and look at that, Wesley Morris up into 10th from what was a midfield start. A fantastic start for the Halcyon Racing guys, with Skye Chmielewski up to 11, Voss down to 12, Wupke from 21st or 22nd up to 13th. He's had a whoop-de-doo start if that keeps going, and Crane just behind too, as they all kind of filter into groups as they reach round the end of the first lap. Problems then for Richard Bayes, Stephen Gordon, and Vernonsen as well in trouble. As I can see Toika steaming into a car, I think, down at the chicane, so that didn't help at all. But Spoliarik leads from Schumacher and Cooper, and that's Cattell through, staying in fourth position from Stanton. Then Walker has got Nemean up into seventh for Milk Racing, so he's definitely milked out that start. From Veit, Junt and Morris, Skye Chmielewski, Voss, and this great baggle of tires from 10th, 11th, 12th and 13th, with Hoekstra just in the back, and Crane's now joined that, as has Jeff Mead, who a couple of races ago was saying he can't stand it anymore. Suddenly he's now in a points paying position, so he might want to keep that going as he gets round Bart DeVos, who's been wrong footed. Oh, into the barrier goes DeVos, somehow scoops it up and keeps it going. The car is still in one piece just about, but that's down to 15th for him as the field continue to stream round. The front guys have kind of let themselves spread out and give themselves a bit of space here on this 24 lap race. As into the pits has come Richard Bayes, Lee Massey's exited it, Stephen Gordon has continued on, but he's in trouble again. So just the two pitters at the end of the opening lap, and who's that changing position? It's Bart DeVos getting past Eric Veit for 12th and 13th, and someone else is changing too. It's Wesley Morris being passed by Marek Skowalski for 9th and 10th, so it's all going wrong. Jeff Mead has just hit Simon Crane in the second chicane, and that wasn't a line of poetry that I wanted to read out, but unfortunately that's true. Prohaska's off down in 30th as well. So people really struggling to get going and find themselves some good clean air here today. Not really going to help themselves out. Someone's in trouble. It's Alex Cooper in fifth position rejoining. He's lost it down into turn one. Let me just see if that was all of his own accord, because I think it was. Yes, it was. He just spun of his own accord into turn one. Rejoins just ahead of Ari Nemian, who is in seventh position for Milk Racing, and he's just about kept the Midnight in it, and that's a front row start. Really, really thrown away there for Alex Cooper, who's now got a feisty Scott and a son of a brother right alongside. That won't help at all. Piled up in T1, what is going on? And I think that is one of our little collections of people once again. And they're off down at the next chicane too. It's Simon Crane in trouble in 23rd position. And that car's not looking good. And Leonowitz is facing into the barriers in 27th. What on earth is going on? It's Simon Crane. That car's got a front puncture on the front right tyre. Thankfully, he's now realised, I think, and is letting people through. But the Waterblue Racing car injured. Leonowitz in 28th was facing problems too, as that looks like Mark Wicks is getting past Nick Newcomb for 24th position, just into the chicane up ahead. So good overtaking going on up and down the field, in between and in and out of plenty of carnage. What else is going on? Spoliarik still leading from Martin Schumacher, and he's trying to break the slipstream as they cross the line to complete lap three. Start lap four, half a second separates them. Cattell now up into third. David Stanton in fourth place, having a great run. Ryan Walker's got Alex Cooper bearing down on him as they go through. So much carnage there down at turn one. I'm sure if they pick up all those pieces together, you'd build half a car. At least. Nemian's still in 7th, then Junt up into 8th. Hoekstra is now 9. Eric Veit in 10th, looking like he wants to throw it in the hedge. Sky Nowowski's now in 11, with Bart DeVos 12. Wesley Morris 13. Toika facing the wrong way in 14th position. That's ruined a points paying position for him, as down the order he goes in a Street Fighter car. It's not often we've seen them in a points position, and I wonder if Timu will be able to keep it there. So up into 14th now goes Boy Vandelaar as he overtakes Lazarus Cagliaglu in the Mazurek car. And Mark Stanton stays behind in the second of the Stanton brothers. He's really not had the luck here today. Now in 16th, just outside the points, but I don't think he'll be sitting there for long. Ed of Sundström, Toika, Lovett, Mead, Abbas, Vernonson, then Newcomb, Leonowitz in 24th. Look at this gaggle, 24, 25, 26, 27. And it's Leonowitz, Gordon, Williamson and Lichtenstein. And Cooper has spun again in turn 7, and that's not going to help. And where is Schumacher? He's down in 5th position. What's happened there for him? I'm just taking a quick look back on the replay and I can't see it, but I think he's had problems out of turn 7, because Alex Cooper's been in trouble again, and that's Schumacher having a go at Ryan Walker down into the final chicane. Not quite able to do it. Oh, it is done! Ryan Walker's got into the barrier! Oh my goodness me. The Wall of Champions does not take feisty Scots, I'm afraid. You can wipe your sporran all over it, but it'll just leave a sticky stain. So, Schumacher apparently spinning at the third chicane. Is he recovering and almost scared? Poor old Walker off into the barrier. Didn't quite know what was happening there, I think. Poor old Ryan, but he's still going in sixth position. It's amazing, the field spread here today, that he's spun and he's still in sixth place, because there's just such a massive field spread, to the point where you've got Gavin Thomas already in 29th position, a minute off the pace before we even get... We're only on lap five already. Nuts. Nuts, 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 hazelnuts. As David Stanton now under a third position, under pressure from Martin Schumacher, and Schumacher's pulling out to have a go down into that. David Stanton, I think he'll get giddy if he stays up there. Oh, smackaroo. And, light's being flashed there, and I don't quite get why. I think Schumacher not really showing his happiness. Showing a Schumacher-esque family trait, I bet. So, you never know. If there was a marshal in this, he might want to give it a push. And what is Stanton there? Letting him through? I don't really see why, because that wasn't necessarily his fault. But David Stanton, a gentleman man. And yeah. Oh, Schumacher's into the pits. Nemian, what's going on there? That was like he missed the corner altogether. I wonder if he was busy watching Schumacher's braking. But no, Schumacher into the pits for repairs. That may be why he's flashing his lights just in frustration, and then maybe Stanton thought, I'll just let him through. We'll never know, but it's very early for a pit stop. Oh, 12th, 13th, 14th, Wesley Morris there bungling the exit out of the chicane, and that's not going to work at all. So, not quite sure. It's all gone a little bit disco fever with all of the flashing of lights. Up front, though, Paulus Boliarik and Simon Cattell battling for the lead. A real battle on our hands, and they've got Gavin Thomas that I think they're about to lap just up ahead as well. As Jeff Meads, our first retirement of the race, he's just DNF'd out, so that's unfortunate for him. He was running in a points-paying position. Not anymore, as Cattell has a look at Spoliarik ever so slightly down into one of the chicanes, but nothing doing there. They've got to watch, because down into the hairpin is going to be the first place that he can try and size him up, but I would be more wise to have a go down into the final chicane. Bourne very heavy on the brakes, not really working at all. And that car in trouble. Thomas flashing his lights. What's going on down this straight? Maybe there's someone with a sign saying honk if you want to go far, or flash if you want to go faster, kind of thing. But they all... at least there's someone flashing back, maybe. We'll never know. Spoliarik once again. I've not seen him this emergency braking under pressure. What they've got to watch, though, is that after Richard Bayes and Christian Prochaska, which they've just all got round, there's a right little gaggle of cars not too far up ahead, although they've started to thin themselves out. And thankfully, I think that was because Prochaska was holding them all up, because he's running a good 10 seconds off the pace and is busy still getting used to the mod and hasn't really been on it. So David Stanton then running in third just behind these two, with Nemean 4, Walker 5, Cooper, Junt, Hoekstra, Veet and DeVos, your top 10. Skynarowski, Vandelaar, Wesley Morris, Timo Toika back up into the points in 14. Daniel Lovett now 15th for Hawkeye, in a good little scrap there just outside the points with Mark Stanton. They're all kind of clutching themselves back together again. Kagiaglu being passed by Morten Vernonsen for 19th position, just off your screens as well, as these two continue to home in. And there's a collection of cars from 23rd, Sundstrom, with Williamson about to dive through. Mark Wicks is there, as is Leonowitz, and Lichtenstein not far behind. They're just entering turn one. Spoliarik's gone too far deep. And, well, he's going for the old switcheroo back through. Well done there, Spoliarik. That was a good recovery. But, my goodness me. Very, very, very close indeed. And Cattell back up behind, fancying another run back through. Down into the chicanes, practically pushing Spoliarik into the corner. Oh, and Cattell now is the one who's in trouble on the exit. I wonder if the tyres are maybe starting to go off, because people are really starting to run a bit ragged. Stanton still looking good in third position. Apologies, it appears that we've got some stuttering on the broadcast. We'll try and see what we can do to rectify that later on. Vandelaar has got in 11th place. He's about to have a go at 11th place, Skynarowski. Vandelaar in 12th, but he's pulled out of that one. Those two very, very close indeed, as the field really have now gone into like little collections, as Martin Schumacher now has a go at Timo Toika for 16th. And, oh, he's going to have to let Toika back through there. He's gone over the anti-cuts, and Toika needs to get his 16th place back. Not sure if Schumacher's giving it, and that won't help at all. No, he's letting back through, and that's all good. So, while the leaders have kind of flolloped themselves out, great little scrapperoo for 4, 5 and 6 between Nemi and Walker and Cooper, Milk, Constant and Midnight. I'm sure there's some kind of filthy joke that I could make in that, but I will try and refrain from sinking down to my Louisville level, especially as there's a jump behind as well. Oh, is Eric V in 8th position trying to go down the outside of Wookie Hopstra? He smacks Wookie. Wookie holds the position, and Eric, once again, he's got a bit of a rep. I may have called him Wookie, I'm sorry. It's too hard to do, but Wookie Hoekstra, again, great defensive driving, but V is so aggressive that he seems to just bash people out of the way. I think he feels that he's part of some kind of Finnish rock band and wants to mosh everyone out of the way. Sorry, a Norwegian rock band. Either way, a lot of that kind of Nordic metal There's only so much rubber a man can take. And Whoopki, once again, keeps it going. Oh, no, he's not! And that's a... Goodness me. I felt like I was about to become some kind of cookie monster with the outcry that I was about to do there. Poor old Whoopki still stays in 10th position, but that was a Wookie cry from Whoopki as he continues on. Second and third retirement simultaneously. Lee Massey and Richard Bates out for Revolution and Epic Motorsports respectively. Another two down. Down, bow, bow. Another one bites the... No. As Milk Racing for Aaron Emian continues on. Cattell busy closing back up to Borna Spoljarek. So that one by no means done either. As who's that? Emian's got his lights on. I think that's to try and warn Prohaska that he's about to be lapped. And Prohaska spins off trying to get out of the way. So that's just as well, really. Have a bath. Oh, as round goes Spoljarek in the lead. He's been hit from behind by Cattell down at the hairpin. My goodness me. Cattell lets it back through. Good gentlemanly behaviour there by Cattell. But Borna, he's been so, well, heavy on the brakes. You can see his wheels are locking up much, much more compared to everyone else's. And apparently he's got a new wheel, I've just been told. And that might be the reason why, as Cattell takes an interesting line out of the chicane. And that's going to give him good traction out of it, and I feel Borna Spoljarek may very well be under threat. He's gone for the inside line and held the position. David Stanton just 5.7 seconds behind these two, running an epic race in third for DSR. You never know, it could all go horribly wrong, and that'll be that, as Nemean pits from seventh, but what was fourth position is now in seventh. So that's our first scheduled pitter, and that's going to help people as he looks like he's going to be joined not too far outside the top 10. Still, Spoljarek and Cattell battle up front. Stanton still 5.6 seconds now behind in third, so he's keeping the gap. Walker and Cooper now released from Nemean's grasp. We'll soon see what kind of speeds they've got, with David Junt in sixth. Then Veet 7, DeVos 8, Hoekstra and Vandalara 9 and 10, with Sky Nowowski and Nemean's rejoined in 12th position. Not in clear air, so that's important. As Martin Schumacher overtaking Wesley Morris for 14th and 15th position. The two have just made contact, and Schumacher's going to have to think about it in a couple of corners' time. Sometimes just barging through does not work. I think Timo Toika has just he's rejoined, but he's in the barriers. So I think that was a disconnection there for Toika for a momentary moment. Still, 30 drivers remaining, 27 on the lead lap. That'll do, and here comes Cattell and Spoljarek, and that's because Cattell's diving for the pits. That was a very interesting move, and that'll be interesting to see what the admin think of that, to be fair. Very interesting indeed, but he's in. We'll soon see what on earth is made of that. So Spoljarek continues on, Stanton now into second. 6.3 off of Spoljarek. Walker and Cooper battling over third and fourth positions. They're dropping David Junt. Eric Veet is now up into sixth position. But I think that Cattell is going to rejoin right alongside him. In fact, no, Veet is through, as is DeVos. Just about. Cattell rejoins in eighth position. Lots of people having problems with the pit lane exit. So he's well ahead of Nemean. They've got Dalar, Hoekstra and Sky Nowowski in between them. Mark Stanton has now battled his way up to 13th, ahead of Wesley Morris, who's still got Martin Schumacher behind him. So good defence in driving there by Wesley Morris. Lovett is in 16th, with Ehab Abbas 17th, then Vernonson 18th, who's just overtaken Timo Toika for 19th. Toika having a go back through. That was never going to work. So those three continue on. Cagliaglu is in 20th, ahead of Stephen Gordon, who's busy recovering from his lap one, turn one dramas. Nick Newcomb's 22nd, Mark Wicks 23rd, Marcus Sundstrom 24, Chris Williamson 25, Leonowitz 26, Lichtenstein and Crane 27 and 28, battling nearly side by side, and Lichtenstein goes over, as does Crane. Both decide that actually let's just not take that chicane whatsoever. But Crane goes through anyway. Liechtenstein, I think, conceding the place because he was just not going to make that anyway. But he's still ahead of teammate Gavin Thomas. Christian Prohaska still going in 30th position, albeit visiting every kitty litter going. And that is Cooper into the pits, as is Bonus Bolyarik. So first and fourth in. David Standen, note it in your books, leads for DSR by 4.2 ahead of Ryan Walker and David Junt. Spoljarek is going to rejoin right alongside Eric Veit, and that could make for an explosive exit, potentially. Spoljarek comes round, and no, Veit is through, and Spoljarek slides in just ahead of DeVos, and Cattell is between them. So that's worked out for Bulner. That really has worked out very nicely indeed, and we're on lap 12 now of 24, so we'll soon see. If he can keep DeVos behind him, then that's a good little barrier that he can use. And Bart DeVos, of course, one of our front runners, and battling with Spoljarek. Well, no, not Spoljarek, he's down 11th in the championship, but he has been one of the more front runners of the race, so we'll soon see what happens with him. Who else is in trouble? I saw someone not quite facing the right way. Sundström just entering the pits with a puncture, that's why. Leonowitz in two from 25 and 26th position. But David Stanton, number one next to his name. Get in. Very nice indeed. Let's see whether he's in. There's Simon Cattell having a go at DeVos. DeVos there, going so far out wide. Not quite sure what was going to happen there. They've got Eric Veit and Spoljarek just up ahead, and Cattell is through before they even get to the chicane. DeVos then goes into the pits anyway, so that was just as well. Cattell absolutely lamps one across things there. Stanton in two, so David Junt now leads. Junt out front. So that's worked out nicely. Stanton, Walker's in the pits as well. DeVos, of course, is in. And the spinner was, I think, Alex Cooper. Because he's now behind Sky Nowalski, and he wasn't before, so that's not worked out for him. Martin Schumacher, now up to 11th position. Ryan Walker, a problem on the pit lane exit. What happened there for him? It was like, Ryan Walker had some kind of game freeze because he gets stuck, for me, three times on the pit lane exit, then has made an absolute bodge of rejoining and now in 13th position, and Bart DeVos goes through. That's a disaster for Ryan Walker, who now, I think, has got a damaged car. Yeah, he's got a left rear puncture, and that, unfortunately, is it. He didn't even get down to the end of the pit lane. He was already in the wall. That was some kind of problem. And then he's had another problem since. He's flashing his lights just to let everyone know and go through. Gentlemanly stuff by the Scot. But unfortunately, that Scot has not got the potential for the podium anymore. Spoljarek has got Cattell closing him down. They've still got Eric Veit up ahead of them. His argy-bargy, norgy-wargy kind of way. And Junt goes through again. For Woods Racing, is he going to try and no-stop it, I wonder? Same with Eric, because David Junt takes another lap in the lead. Cattell running very out wide to the wall there. Watch out for Vandelaar in fifth position, just keeping a watching brief too. David Stanton rejoined in sixth, ahead of Nemean, crucially, and Hoekstra. Cooper now in nine, ahead of Marek, who is still in 10. Martin Schumacher now into 11th position. That's a little bit more like where we expect a Schumacher to be these days. We have a Bass has just overtaken Mark Stanton for 15th and 16th position. Stanton's having another run back through again, so the Royal Blue versus the Water Blue. Hell of a lot of blue going on. It may be black and blue if one of them ends up in the Wall of Champions. Stanton, last of the late breakers, has taken the position, and that is a good clean move there by Mark Stanton, who showed such good pace in qualifying. Stephen Gordon just in the background outbreaking himself. Ehab fancying a run back through again, but I think he's too far back to make a go of it. But yeah, Mark Stanton back up into the points. And for someone who was comfortably in the top 10 in quali, I think you'd have been hoping for more. But brother David certainly giving it large for DSR. And that will do, as Bulner Spoljarek has got Cattell for third and fourth. Again, Spoljarek That car so unsettled under braking. And Veet, I think, is holding them, but I don't think Veet's going to pit. And they've got a couple of cars to lap as well. They've got Sundstrom and Leonowitz they're coming up to. David Jun, too. And Borna feeling the need to go defensive. Someone's off in the final chicane, but they're clear again before they get there. And look at the way they come out. Rubbish on board camera, come back. So Junt continues round. Veet now just 2.7 behind, and he's being pushed now because Spoliarik and Cattell are on it. Van der Laar a further 4.5 seconds back, not really pressuring. And Ryan Walker has retired with suspension failure, so that's another one out. And Leonowitz, who I said I saw someone going off, that was him retiring out. So we're now down to 27 drivers remaining. So attrition starting to come in the second half of this race. Lap 15 of 24, we are on. David Junt now leading by 2.2. The gap is closing. They've got Sundstrom in between, who's looking like he's getting well out of the way. Good stuff there, Marcus. You're doing very well. As Veet Spoljarek. Oh, he's cut right across in front of Cattell, though. Oh, dear. I think that was a little bit of a Nordic nudge. As they come down to the hairpin. And Veet. Oh, Spoljarek. That car, it looks like it's pulling to the left when it brakes, and I think that's the problem with it. It just looks so much unsettled compared to everyone else. Either that or it's just been run ragged and it can't cope. So Veet now very much under attack as we come down to the final chicane. What's Veet going to do? He lets him through, and Spoljarek, oh, he's cut across. He'll have to give that one back, I think. And be careful about it, because Cattell was thinking, I shall try. Spoljarek flashes his lights. Veet's going through. Can Cattell try and make the most of it? No, he's too far back. Spoljarek does very well to just blend right in behind Eric. And that will do very nicely indeed. Good M1 driving by those three. As they continue on down. Niemeyen still ahead of Cooper. Something's going on. Wupke Hoekstra's had to pit from what was ninth. That's a late stop there by the Wookiee. And that won't help at all. Wesley Morris has got past Chris Williamson for 17th and 18th positions. That's all. It's a change of circumstances. Cagliaglu, 21st position in the gravel. But obviously he's decided that he's going to take a tour. And he's rejoined right in front of Simon Crane. He's pushed him into the wall! What on earth? 21st position, 22nd there. Simon Crane somehow managed to get out of it. And there we go. He's obviously gone, sorry. Oh, little love nudge on the exit there. Yo, tap in your rear. And Simon Crane, that flash says it all. Martin Schumacher, P10, having a go at Sky Nowowski as well. And he's going to try and have a go down the outside into the third chicane. That won't work. Eric's too good for that one. But Martin Schumacher on the edges of the top 10, and that would do quite nicely indeed as Nick Newcomb pits from what was 18th and 19th positions. That will do. As Borna Spoljarek, now up into P2, he's got past Eric. Where did that happen? That was down at the hairpin as Schumacher barges through. But my goodness me, that was an interesting move there. And Borna Spoljarek at the same place has got past Eric Veet for second position. He's right up behind Junt. They've caught him. Just 1/10 behind. David Junt pulls to the inside. He's got worn tyres. Borna's going to try and go around the outside. Can he hold it on? He's gone into the white lines. He might tap. Junt, no. And Veet there under attack from Cattell. Four drivers all battling for the lead of this race. And Junt desperately, grimly trying to hold on lap 17 of 24. It's a long, long, winding road. Is that a Cagliaglu song? Cagliaglu. It's Cattell battling all over Veet, Spoljarek all over Junt. And you have to say, it's almost like they all want to reverse positions to really what their speeds are. And that's what's making this so exciting. As Martin Schumacher in more trouble and has dropped down to 10th position. And it's all got a bit Noah's Ark. Here come our pitters versus our non-pitters. Borna's through on Junt. Cattell is through on Veet. and Cattell automatically lining straight up on Junt because Junt's a little bit wrong-footed on the exit of that chicane. Junt goes to the inside, he's got two wheels on the grass, that will never stop if you brake now. But thankfully he's thought better of it, but Cattell already through. And Junt now under attack from Veet as well. And well, they've cleared him. It's back again. Thomas Bodlarek versus Simon Cattell, Turret Motorsport versus Innovision. I think Veet is going to have a go for RMI Motorsports on the wood racing of David Junt. He's through before they get there. David, I think, maybe thinking of his tyres, to be fair. I don't think he expected to be quite so high up the order because he's must want to try and save them as best he can. Boy van der Laar in 5, just keeping a watch in brief. How far is he off the leader? He's 4.2 off our leader, so he'll have a go. David Stanton, still 9 seconds off the lead, doing a great job in 6th now, ahead of Niemann and Cooper. Sky now asking Martin Schumacher, as Bonus Boljarek steaming into that curb. Next up to be lapped, Nick Newcombe, who is currently sitting in 22nd position, still unlapped, despite losing an awful lot of time earlier on, as Marcus Sundström is retired with suspension failure. And you be careful, guys, Mr. Cutmeister. We're not Flymo. Practically mowing the grass in some of these occasions. As they come out, you've got to be very careful. It's so easy to try and straight line these chicanes, and you need to know exactly where the rules lie. And Nick Newcombe not letting them through. Spoljarek very dodgy on the exit. Newcombe cuts right across, so I think he'll pull out of the way now. Spoljarek flashes his lights, and Nick now gets out of the way. So one of them going, I think he's in a wee bit of trouble as they're now flashing to say thank you very much. And I don't know what Cattell might try and do down at the end of the straight. I don't think he's close enough to do anything, to be fair. Oh, Spoljarek. What is he doing? He's getting his booty call on by the time it gets down. It was like he was going to try and unsettle the car for some kind of Gymkhana slide through the final turn. That was never going to work. My cameraman producer in the ear says a Scandinavian flick. I thought that was some kind of position. Never know. There's Niemann and Cooper for 7 and 8, actually. I thought that was going to be side by side into turn 1. Cooper pops out to have a look, but he can't do anything of it. Niemann is so defensive, it's untrue, and Cooper's got nowhere to go. So that's sorted for the time being. Everyone else still behaving relatively well, although Mark Wicks and Gordon, battling over 16 and 17 is looking juicy. But this lead battle is the best of the bunch. Pick an accent. Picked a dialect, I'll have a go. As Cattell continues to battle with Mr. Spoljarek. So, Cattell, where is he in the championship? He's down 7th with only 25 points. This is great for him. He's desperately trying to get back up the order because he's had a torrid start to the season. Just 2 races ago after this, he needs to be best placed. Borna may do better to finish the championship. Simon Crane, next one up to be lapped. Running in 21st place. It's once again not really good on the entry to that final chicane. Kagiaglu and Morris just a couple of seconds further up the road as well. As who's that changing position? Alex Cooper, P8. Alongside Ari Niemann down into the final chicane. Is that a good position take going on? I think it is. Cooper's through, bouncing across the curves. That's been a long time coming. Niemann, having a fantastic defensive drive. Oh, as Martin Schumacher overtakes Bart DeVos illegally on the exit of the chicane in the background, so Bart goes back through again. So he will be doing the Bartman. And well, Martin Schumacher, dirty tricks. I think it runs in the family. A little bit of cutting there as well. As soon as you do Flymo down into turn one, you know it's wrong. I feel. Everyone else continuing on quite nicely. Simon Crane not letting leaders through just yet. as they approach. I think now would be a good time to do so, maybe running wide down at the hairpin if he doesn't pull over, but he's pulling over nice and early. Good driving there by Sight. Thank you very much. Spoliarek once again looking interesting, as is Cattell. Oh! Has he hit the barrier? That was an awful camera angle that I was stuck at, but he ran so far out wide. Bizarre there by Cattell, but that has gifted some time back to Spoliarek, who's immediately on trying to get onto the back of Chris Williamson. And Eric Veit now suddenly is all over the back of Cattell. Might be worthwhile to have a little stab up the inside, as once again Cattell struggling. It's like they are playing past the brake problem. It's bizarre. So anyway, but that chicane, hairpin, sorry, just choose a corner, Simon. Down at the hairpin, as soon as you're offline into that, there's a definite filter feel, or a definite line. And as soon as you go past it onto the outside, there's no grip whatsoever, and you spear off and you look awful and wobbly just trying to go round the outside. Nemean's now fallen into the power of Marek Skynowski for the 8th and 9th, so I don't know if his tyres have gone, as Marek's having to go through, and that didn't quite work. So once again, plenty of chopping shop going on. As they cut, Stefan Gordon smacks the barriers in 16th position. Mark Wicks is off on the grass in 17th. What on earth is going on? So, still... Eric. Goodness me. I don't mean to give him a little bit of a... there's Prohaska. Oh, Veit. He was a little bit judging that Christian actually has some pace. There's something going on in the background as well. It's David Stanton trying to lap about 12 cars at once because they've all appeared together. So still Spoliarek, Cattell, Veit, Dallard, Junt and Stanton, your top six. And those six well clear of the rest. And so many cars all just kind of get out of the way as Mark Wicks pops into the pits. Lap 22 we're starting of 24. It's been an interesting race, a little bit of a all over the shot one. So the gap now 3.1 between those two. Van der Laar still sitting in 4. So that's all gravy. 8th and 9th still battling away between Ari Nemean and Marek Skynowski. Knock Racing versus Royal Blue. Bart DeVos keeping a watching brief in 10. Martin Schumacher is still in 11th. So once again, not quite a top 10. Oh, is Stefan Gordon in the wall in 16th position as Wesley Morris moves over to be lapped. Stefan Gordon for Hawkeye. Every time I've clicked on the guy, he's not facing the right way or having a drama. Yet that's only the first time he's been lapped. So obviously he's got quite good pace when he's facing the right way, which is a shame. But yeah, Hawkeye by name, certainly not by nature, unless you're just playing Angry Birds. As Morris having a little look in 17th, and Morris not really on the black stuff. Then we've got Kagiglu, Williamson, Newcomb round out the top 20, then Simon Crane, Mark Wicks has rejoined. Then a red 5 battle for 23rd and 24th position. Christoph Lichtenstein and Gavin Thomas going at it, hammer and tongs. They're not even in wooden spoon positions. Go red 5. And, well, being a backmarker myself, I know the pain of what it's like as Lichtenstein runs out well wide, and Gavin Thomas, who had an early stop, desperately trying to get back through. So, as Cattell gains ever so slightly, Stanton's closed in on John. Oh, Gavin Thomas into the bowl from 24th position. Well, it was good while it lasted. That was a good old giggle. Fifth and sixth position, nope. David Junt needs to get on a growth stunt if he wants to get some better lap times in, because David Stanton's closed him down quite nicely indeed. David somehow clinging on. Sans pit stop. He's got two left to go to cling on to David. And I feel that David Stanton, with his new tyres and what has been an absolutely mature drive today, should bear him some good route. They've got Cagliari just up ahead. We will have to move out of the way relatively soon. And Lazarus certainly not doing anything biblical here today, as Simon Crane and Nick Newcomb for 20th and 21st swapping positions. Simon Crane moves up into 20th. Newcomb having a go to try and go back through. And I think Newcomb's going to go. Come back, come back. That's Alaska you're going to, Nick. And that's not worked, as Daniel Lovett has retired. Oh, that was ages ago. And Newcomb and Crane, once again, side by side. It's like one car's buggered up their straight line speed and one car's buggered up their cornering. It's like banger racing. It's all gone horribly wrong as Mark Stanton's off the track in 12th, but stays in his position. And Crane gets it at last. Newcomb has to settle as we start the last lap then. Borna Spoljarek well clear of Cattell, with Veit third, Vandelaar four, Junt five, and Stanton's dropped back ever so slightly now in sixth position. So that's not worked for him. Niemann's still in eighth position behind Alex Cooper, with Sky Jarmowski still behind. Martin Schumacher now in tenth because Bart De Vos has been in trouble and has dropped down to 11th. Not sure what happened there. With Mark Stanton and Wupke Hoekstra, 12 and 13. Vernonsen and Abashid, point scorers currently at the moment, and they're well clear of the rest of the field. So it looks like these are the 15 that will happen to score, because everyone else actually after that has been lapped. So they can absolutely go to jelly, and it won't matter. And we'll see what's going on with that. So it's been an absolutely bizarre race, as these rounds have continued to be quite fair. But entertaining, nonetheless. I'll give it that. But once again, the men who stand tall, the men who gain the points, are the ones who have least decided to kick it up the Kyver. Although Spoljarek desperately trying to at the final corner, and Cattell into the wall coming out there. But Borna Spoljarek, once again, a great result there. Fantastic wins here for the Canadian Grand Prix. For our WSS series here, Cattell finishes second, just 2 seconds behind. Veit gets third with Lalar four. Junt five, just beating home Stanton in sixth with Cooper seven. Niemann is going to hold off Marek just out of the final corner, so the cow does it. So he likes to move it. Ahead of Sky Nowowski, Martin Schumacher, 10th position. That really does sum up his Schumacher's year, really, to be fair. De Vos 11, Wupke Hoekstra just about clears Stanton, and that's a change of position because Stanton was ahead of him coming into the last lap. Let's whoopee on the Wookie. What's he going to do? That must have been what he was doing. You know, like when you're running the 100 metres and you have to dip for the line? I've got this vision of Wookie as a Wookie just going, pushing his head forward as he crosses, giving birth out of the labia of the front wing comes Wookie. Ahead of Mark Stanton, Morten Vernonsen, and he have a bass. Your final score is there, getting your bass on. One lap down and out of the points. Hawkeye's Stephen Gordon ahead of Wesley Morris, who was a shame there. He's driving really well earlier. Lazarus. I can't say it. I just want to say the band name. Cagliari, sticky situation. Simon Crane beat home Nick Newcomb for 19 and 20, with Chris Williamson 21st. Mark Wicks 22nd, a lap down as well. Never really got going. I saw him at least 5 feet off the ground in turn one through no fault of his own. The two red fives, Lichtenstein of the Christoph variety, beat home Gavin Thomas for 23rd and 24th. Then 3 laps down and again finishing Christian Prohaska. So much better there, to be fair. And his fastest lap was a 1:42.5, which was significantly better than anything he vaguely managed in qualifying. So it's good to see. A little bit of practice, Christian, and I think you'll be up with the rest of us. Retirements, Marcus Sundström. Timo Toika, Ryan Walker, Matt Leonowitz, Daniel Lovett, Lee Massey, Richard Bayes and Jeff Mead. And Tom Parker didn't even get going. So apologies for the choppiness in the stream. So we shall see. Excitement round. And I shall save, actually, the story that I was going to leave for warm-up for a certain little broadcast that will be coming up on the weekend of the 23rd and 24th of June, where Simon Melhuish, the cameraman extraordinaire, and myself, and maybe a few others as well. I'm sure there's a few others, otherwise I will be talking to myself for a whole 24 hours! 24-hour broadcast here for simrace.tv, where one of the runners, Luntz, is hosting a rather fantastic event. We'll have a German stream, but we'll be on the English one, so come and join us, because we're far much more fun. Unless you just want to be shouted at slightly angrily for 24 hours. I can do that, but I come with added filth, for want of a better word. Now it'll be week end of the 23rd and 24th, so 2 weekends time, Saturday, Sunday. Book your diaries out, that's going to be an absolute classic. We'll obviously be back for the normal Open Wheeler event next Thursday, where someone will be commentating for you. And then we'll also be back because we've still got 2 rounds left to go of this, presuming that it's all going to be broadcasted on. I'm assuming it will. I'll just throw it out there. And we've got, I know it ends in the Wanderous Runderous Nordschleife, but we've got one to go before that. But I can't remember where we are going. I'm thinking Turkey, yeah. I knew it was an animal. I was just trying to... How many countries are there that's got an animal in it, Simon? Welcome to Koala Bear thingy. Veet has just managed to disqualify himself from the results because he drove backwards down the track. And quick stats, 3rd, 4th and 5th were the 3 that didn't pit, and that definitely worked out for them. So, super Madupa. And we got a couple of interviewees. Do like a collection in the chat room. First up, winner, Bornos Boljarek. Kept nice and occupied for most of that race by Simon Cattell, but eventually you won through there, Borna. Well done.
Yeah, thank you. I didn't really practice much for this race, around an hour, and I knew that the only good chance for any good position in this race was just being consistent, and it seemed that everyone that was behind me either spun out or just got lost on the track, so that was it.
And I was told by a little tweety in my ear, you've got a new wheel today. Did that help, hinder? What's the difference between the two?
Yeah, I have a do-it-yourself wheel, and I couldn't attach it on G27 today, so it was a bit tough to race with that little practice, but it went really okay.
Excellent stuff, excellent stuff. What wheel have you got, if you don't mind? Oh no, sorry, you've said a DIY one. No, my fault. Don't mind me, dribbler. So, 2 races left to go, Turkey and here. This now puts you in pole position, obviously, in the championship, now that you beat out your clearest or nearest rivals, because Cattell, although he was your rival on the track today, he's not in the championship. Feeling good?
Yeah, I just go into the championship being consistent. The speed really doesn't matter, because as you can see today, I was like the 4th fastest, but again, I won. So it's just being consistent and getting all the points available, and that's it.
Awesome stuff. We do like point whores. Also in the booth, we've got David Jump, who, well, stunted his points total quite nicely today with a handy fifth and non-stopping as well. Well done.
Thanks, but well, it's no use for me actually because I've just reached a 5-4 point at this race and I've had about 1 hour of practice and I think 16 hours probably good enough on the starting grid. But the thing is just, I just didn't find the setup that I liked, that the car was just coming round as soon as I was steering into a corner and I was thinking if I don't spin all race, I'll be already happy with that.
Excellent stuff. Well, it seems to me that only bothering to do an hour of practice seems to win the best results at the moment. Not that I advocate that. Bad people. But never mind. Thank you very much. We'll be at Turkey next. Fancy your chances for anything good there, Dave?
Oh, well, it really depends if I have to stand in again, but I'm really successful as a standing driver at the moment. if it would work like this, I mean, at the start, I was tangled inside of the midfield. Someone spun in front of me. I couldn't avoid it. Someone tapped my back. I had damage at the front of the back. It was still drivable, and I was going for a 4-0 stop anyway. So I just tried to bring it home, and I've let everyone go who was beside me. So leading laps and having some bit of fun and being at the front, that was a really great result for us and for with racing. I hope Ollie's going to see that too.
Excellent stuff. Well, I think that just about brings us to the end of the old broadcaster here today. I'd like to thank Simon Melhuish for, as ever, being the silent assassin in the background there. And don't forget, we'll be back next week for the Open Wheelers and then in 2 weeks' time for round five of the WSS series here for GPVWC. If you're quite fancy getting involved in the action, pop along to gpvwc.com. Sign yourself up for some funky action. My name's Simon Smith. You lot take care of yourselves. If you're going to do something that I would do, put a rubber on it.
Sieben, acht, neun.